I am Anna Zavelsen. I will sing Wie Melodien sieht es mir by Johannes Brahms. Pietà Signora by Anonymous Composer.
My name is Shreya Phillips. I will sing Do You Want to Build a Snowman from the musical Frozen. Elsa? Do you want to build a snowman? Come on, let's go and play. I never see you anymore. Come out the door, it's like you've gone away. We used to be best buddies, and now we're not. I wish you would tell me why. Do you want to build a snowman? It doesn't have to be a snowman. Okay, bikes around the halls. I think some company is overdue. I've started talking to the pictures on the walls. It gets a little lonely, all these empty rooms, just watching the hours tick by. The Tree from the musical The Me Nobody Knows. Baby apple now.
Lydia Tracy, and I'm going to be singing Home from Wonderland. Notes today from Shrek the Musical.
There's a princess in a tower. Oh my gosh, that's just like me. Poor Rapunzel needs a haircut, but the witch won't set her free. She passes time by singing like someone else I know. As years go by, she sits and waits.
As years go by.
A torturous existence.
I don't remember this part.
She wishes she were dead. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, Rapunzel finds a millionaire. The prince is good at climbing and braiding. There's a princess in a coma. Glad it's her instead of me. Pretty maiden in a glass box. How I wonder, does she pee? Blah, 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 blah. Poison apple, boring, boring, evil queen. Filler, filler, been there, read that. Seven shorties on the scene. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, the princess wakes up with a start. The prince is good at kissing and melting Snow White's heart. So I know he'll appear and his armor will be blinding, as shining as his perfect teeth. In manly pose, he'll propose on one knee, and our prenup will be binding. Show up today.
is Lindsay Alexander. I will sing Heart, We Will Forget Him by Aaron Copland. By Claude Debussy.
Thank you. My name is Selena Mu. I will sing How Are Things in Glockamora from Finian's Rainbow.
I hear a bird, Glockamora bird. It's well, maybe it's bringing me a cheering word. I hear a breeze, a river shedding breeze. It's well, maybe it's followed me across the seas. Then tell me, please, how are things in Glockamora? Is that a little brook still leaping there? Does it still run down to Donnycarn?
Wrong Guys from Kinky Boots. Oh no, don't you dare. Girl, 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 I'm warning you. No, I think of a crush. I can't. I think of falling for him. Oh no. Why not? Woman have been making bad choices since the beginning of time. Are you gonna be another one of mine? Uh-oh. Used to think you were from outer space. Who's this bright-eyed guy in your place? You're kind of cute when you're not so shy. Uh-oh. But I've been here before. Have I come back from more? Another chapter in the history of wrong guys. You used to be so eh, all lip, lackluster, bore.
Parade, arranged by Joan Frey Boyton.
Bags full of
I'm Marita Tomlinson. I will sing Caro Mio Ben by Giuseppe Giordani. The Little Red Lark, arranged by William Arms Fisher.
Thank you. is Emmett Wise, and today I'll be singing The Wonderful Thing About Tiggers from The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh.
The wonderful thing about tiggers, these tiggers are wonderful things. Their tops are made out of rubber, their bottoms are made out of springs. They're bouncy, trouncy, flouncy, pouncy, fun, 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 fun. But the most wonderful thing about tiggers is I'm the only one. Oh, the wonderful thing about tiggers is tiggers are wonderful chaps. They're loaded with thin and with vigor, they love to leap in your laps. They're clumpy, thumpy, bumpy, thumpy, fun, 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 fun. But the most wonderful thing about tiggers is I'm the only one. Oh, tiggers are cuddly fellows, tiggers are awfully sweet. Everyone else is jealous, that's why I repeat and repeat. The wonderful thing about tiggers is tiggers are wonderful things. Their tops are made out of rubber, their bottoms are made out of springs. They're bouncy, trouncy, flouncy, pouncy, fun, 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 fun. But the most wonderful thing about tiggers is I'm the only one.
The Perfect Nanny from Mary Poppins.
Thank you.
Polish song compiled by John Boyton.
I'm Marita Tomlinson. I will sing Goodnight My Someone from The Music Man.
My love, sleep tight.
Shy from Once Upon a Mattress.
Someone's being bashful.
And bays, dapples and grays, who just takes a little horse. years, and there's nothing so good at the laugh. It's a charm for the darkest dose, oh, oh, and it lightens the doctor's bills, oh, oh. White food and it's on and it's in, oh, oh, and it's brought to the world of care, oh, oh. Well, there's nothing so good by half as a jolly good hearty laugh.
Things that I hadn't thought to explore. They were of my I am Caitlin Black. I will be singing Home from Beauty and the Beast.
Yes, I made the choice, for Papa I will stay, but I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way, you monster. If you think that what you've done is right, well then, you're a fool. Think again. Is this home? Is this where I should learn to be happy? Never dreamed that a home could be dark and cold. I was told every day in my childhood, even when we grow old, home will be where the heart is. Never were words so true. My heart's far, far away. Home is too. Is this home? Is this what I must learn to believe in? Try to find something good in this tragic place. Just in case I should stay here forever, held in this empty space. Oh, but that won't be easy. I know the reason why. My heart's far, far away. Home's a lie. What I give to return to the life that I knew lately, and to think I've complained of that dull provincial town. Is this home? Am I here for a day or forever? Shut away from the world until who knows when. Oh, but then, as my life has been altered, once it can change again. Build higher walls around me, change every lock and key. Nothing lasts, nothing holds all of me.
Alyssa Green from The Prom.
The hair has to be perfect. The A's have to be straight. You have to join the debate club. On that, there's no debate. You'll have Bible camp each summer to keep you pure and clean. Endless rules apply when you're Alyssa. Trophies have to be first place, ribbons have to be blue. There's always some competition or hoops for jumping through. Your mom's made sacrifices, so win homecoming queen, 'cause it's do or die when you're Alyssa Green. And you wish there was a world where you were simply free to live, and when people criticized you, you had no more shits to give. And in this other lifetime, when you tell yourself be brave, you won't cave. cracked. If you don't like shaking pom-poms, you better learn to act. Just have everything perfected by the time you reach 18. Don't ask how or why when you're a listener green. Improve all of your strong points and hide things that you lack. Cause mom's convinced if you're perfect, your father might come back. You're not yourself, you're not what she wants, you're someone in between. Your whole life's a lie when you're a listener green.
My name is Selena Mu. I will sing The Daisies by Samuel Barber.
In the scented bud of the morning moon, when the windy grass was drooping far, I saw my dear one walking slow in the field where the daisies are. We did not laugh and we did not speak as we wandered happily to and fro. I kissed my dear on either cheek in the bud.
The Lass from the Low Country by John Jacob Niles.
My name is Ainsley Gilbert. I will sing 100 Easy Ways to Lose a Man from Wonderful Town. Chapter 1. Now the first way to lose a man, You've met a charming fellow and you're out for a spin. The motor fails and he just wears a helpless grin. Don't bat your eyes and say, what a romantic spot we're in. Just leap out, crawl into the car, say it's a gasket, and fix it in 2 seconds flat with a bobby pin. That's a good way to lose a man. He takes you to a baseball game, you sit knee to knee. He says the next man up a bat will bunt, you'll see. Don't say, ooh, what's a bunt? This game's too hard for little me. Just say, are you nuts? With no outs, two men on base, and a left-handed batter coming up, you walk right into a triple play just like it happened in the fifth game in the World Series in 1923. That's a sure way to lose a man. A sure, 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 sure way to lose a man. A splendid way to lose a man. Just throw your knowledge in his face. He'll never try for second base. 98 ways to go. The third way to lose a man. The lifeguard at the beach that all the girlies adore swims bravely out to save you through the ocean's roar. Don't say, oh thanks, I would have drowned in just 1 second more. Just push his head onto the water, yell, last one in is a rotten egg, and race him back to shore. That's a swell way to lose a man. You found your perfect mate and it's been love from the start. He whispers, you're the one to who I give my heart. Don't say, I love you too, my dear, let's never, never part. Just say, I'm afraid you've made a grammatical error. It's not to who I give my heart, it's to whom I give my heart. You see, with the use of the preposition to, who becomes the indirect object, making the use of whom imperative, which I can easily show you by drawing a very simple chart. That's a fine way to lose a man. A fine, 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 fine way to lose a man. A dandy way to lose a man. Just be more well-informed than he. You'll never hear, oh, promise me. Just show him where his grammar errs. Then mark your towels hers and hers. Yes, girls, you too can lose your man if you will use my simple plan. 100 easy ways to lose a man. Raining from Rocky the Musical. Watch him turn his collar up against the wet. Stops a passerby and bums a cigarette. Ducks inside a doorway and I see him strike a light. Pulls me back to everything I've ever known. Papa sudden rages, Mama turned to stone. Praying for Saint Anthony to come and make things right. But you don't look up and you don't talk back and your odds are 10 to 9. Like a weed that grows from a pavement crack toward a patch of sign. You hide yourself in a tiny space as the voices rise. And you go someplace where no one ever cries. Well, if it keeps on raining, I think I might float away. Yes, if it keeps on raining, I may. The sky is one day. finishes his cigarette and throws it down. Gives a little wave and then he heads downtown. Fading in the darkness till he's finally gone from sight. But I don't look up and I don't wave back, 'cause my odds are 10 to 9. That a weed stays put in the pavement crack and it never finds a sign. I fit myself in my tiny space as the waters rise. And I wonder if he'll be back again with his broken face and his hard luck life and his sad brown eyes. And if it keeps on raining, I think I might float away. Yes, if it keeps on raining, I may. The sky is
Lindsay Alexander. I will sing The Light in the Piazza from The Light in the Piazza. I don't see a miracle shining from the sky. Thank you. when he sees me from Waitress the Musical.
I stick with real things, usually facts and figures. When information's in its place, I minimize the guessing game. Guess what? I don't like guessing games or when I feel things before I know the feeling. How am I supposed to operate if I'm just tossed around by fate? Like on an unexpected date with a stranger who might talk too fast or ask me questions about myself before I decided that he can ask me questions about myself. He might sit too close or call the waiter by his first name, Oreos, but eat the cookie before the cream. But what scares me the most is what if when he sees me, what if he doesn't like it? What if he runs the other way and I can't hide from it? What happens then if when he knows me, he's wholly disappointed? What if I give myself away to only get it given back? I couldn't live with that. So I'm just fine inside my shell-shaped mind. This way I get the best view, so that when he sees me, I want him to. I'm not defensive, I'm simply being cautious. I can't risk reckless dating due to my miscalculating why. A certain suitor stands in line, I've seen in movies, most made for television. You cannot be too careful when it comes to sharing your life. I could end up a miserable wife. Sorry, girls, but he could be criminal. Some sort of psychopath who escaped from an institution somewhere where they don't have girls. He could have masterminded some way to find me. He could be colorblind. How untrustworthy is that? He could be less than kind. Or even worse, he could be very nice, have lovely eyes, and make me laugh, come out of hiding. What do I do with that?